All right, just want to do a video on my plants, vegetables, banana plants and stuff. Probably more so for myself than anyone else, so I can see the difference in them. And probably do an update on it in 2 or 3 weeks or something like that, so I can see the difference of how fast they're actually growing since I see them every day. One thing I'm into is bananas, and this is an ice cream banana, which was a pup off of the bigger ice cream banana that I got on the other side of the yard. And none of my bananas, out of 4 different kinds, I've got basically 2 that made it, even though we had a really mild winter. But got 3 coming back from this one, which I think only had 2 growing in here last year. And they've come up quick, really, in 2 weeks, pretty much all of this. And these are some that I just pulled out of another yard. These are non-bearing, if you will, just ornamental. I've got several of those popping up. But none out of the biggest, if you will. None coming back from the biggest plant. Well, it's all the same plant. This is my lime tree that brought it out a little bit early. So when I did, it kind of shocked it and dropped a bunch of leaves, but the leaves are coming back good. Man, I got buds all over this thing, so that's great. Now if they'll just hold on and make limes instead of falling off, because they really do have a tendency to fall off. See if I can kind of zoom in on some of these. They're real thin right there where the flowers come off, and they have a tendency to break off and even fall off if you're watering too much or not enough. But I got them popping up everywhere, so hopefully we're going to have some limes, because the limes that I got off of it last year were probably some of the best limes I've ever ate, and I'm assuming that's probably because they were fresh and I've never had fresh limes. So yeah, here's Bristol and Lex, the mean yellow lab. Oh, and hey, here's it's Saturday, and I wanted to say to 1968 Hambone, thanks so much, man. Got the iced tea going. I know it's hard to see. Yeah, it's hard to, kind of hard to see the engraving where I've got it here from all the humidity and everything. But Elk Nut 75 did the Texas on the bottom. That was awesome, man. I appreciate that. I really do. So to go with the limes, I tried a little bit different type of mint. This is a mint lemon. And my whole purpose of the limes and the mint is to make mojitos. Give me some Nicaraguan Florida caña and a little bit of this mint lemon, some fresh limes off there, man. We'll be good to go. This is a ladyfinger. My good friend Troy up in Idaho, of all places to get a banana plant from, or banana tree, he sent it to me, I'm going to say here, probably about 2 weeks ago again, and it's already put out 2 new leaves, and of course one of them's flopped over because of all the wind that we've had. But man, that thing's doing good. I just got to give it a few more weeks, and then I'll put it into a different planter. So here, got the cilantro going. It's looking good. And I had a big hibiscus last year, but of course it doesn't make it through the winter here, regardless of pretty much how mild it is. But I decided to buy a smaller plant this year because the other one grew so fast. I figured, why spend the money on something? But this thing's got blooms all over it. It's only got 1 out right now. But beautiful red blooms on this thing. I may actually try to save this one this year. I may move it inside with some of the bananas and stuff and go from there. This is possibly a failed experiment off my peach tree. It had a big old sucker coming out, and I thought, well, maybe I'll try to cut it and see if possibly I can get it to grow. It's come back some, so it's actually doing better than what I thought. This banana plant is, this was the original ice cream banana that I had. Sorry about all the sun. And I thought it was dead, but, and if I can get out of the sun here, here in the last 2 days, all of a sudden, I've got growth. So it looks like, oh wow, actually I just now noticed this one right here. Hey, I guess I need to actually steal some dirt out of there. I guess I probably need to get some more in there to make sure they're going. Let's see, Black Beauty eggplant. So we've got that one going. The jumbo jalapeno. It's already got some small blooms on it, making some. This is the patio container tomato. It's got tomatoes pretty much all over it, and these are looking great, man. They have really, in just the last few, 1 week, have just gotten huge. It's got a big group of them somewhere right in there. This is my Cajun bell peppers that are going. I've only had those a couple of days in there, and they've already put out all kinds of leaves. And my black cherry tomato plant, it's got a lot of blooms that are going there, if you can see that. It's looking good. And one more jalapeno plant. He's already got some, they've actually got one growing down there that's looking good. They're coming along. So, I'll back off here and get one more shot just so I can kind of compare this after I take another video in about 2 or 3 weeks. And see what we can find out. Or see what they actually do. I'm actually ready to get some vegetables off there. Oh, and one other thing to mention, the reason why I'm doing everything in containers, I've actually got plenty of room here in the yard that I could do, you know, I could do a small garden and actually get a heck of a lot more plants than what I have in the containers. But the problem is that I have about 6 inches of soil in this yard. And once you get below about 6 inches, it is a solid slab of limestone that varies anywhere from a foot to about 3 foot thick. So actually all the trees and everything that I've planted, I've actually had to use a jackhammer to break through that. And it's just too big a pain in the butt. If I do a garden, I'd have to do like an elevated garden. And I don't know, I guess I'm just not quite that motivated yet. So, well, until the next update.